Well, hello everyone, welcome. My name is Pastor Roland. Today I want to talk about how to find God, or how to know God. And what I want to begin by saying is you can't find God in a book. You can't study your way to God. So how are you going to find God? Well, you don't have to go to a mountain somewhere. You don't have to go to a monastery. You can find God right now, in this very moment. Let me give you a couple of hints. You won't find God in your imagination. You won't find God down in thoughts, thinking. Not that thinking is wrong, but you won't find him in trying to analyze and scheme and plan and figure things out. And another hint, you won't find God if you're resentful. He may reach out to you in your resentful state and begin to draw you near to him, but if he does, then you will need to see that there's something wrong with resentment and judgment toward other people, being hateful and impatient, being impatient with your children. So here's the biggest hint of all. You begin to find God when you get closer to your conscience. When your conscience makes you aware that you did something that wasn't quite right, like, for example, you were impatient with your children, or you resented someone, or you hated someone, you might become aware that you hated your dad, or you hated your mom. See? Something like that. Then, if you can just bear the pain of seeing that truth, seeing that you're wrong, and admitting that you're wrong and realizing that you can't change yourself, you can't make yourself right, you've always tried, you can't make yourself right. All you can do is see that you're wrong and be sorry. Regret that you're wrong. See? Regret what you see about yourself. That will be the beginning of your getting to know God more and more. It begins with what the Christians call repentance. Okay? So, what you might try is you might try my little meditations. Some of them are free because they help you to stand back from thought. See, right now you're lost in worries, doubts, and fears. And who talks to you down in your worries, doubts, and fears? It's not God, but it's the guy with the horns. The guy with the horns is down there, always misleading you, always fooling you, okay, leading you astray. All right, so you need to get out of that. So you need to stand back from your worries, doubts, and fears, and thinking in your imagination. Come back to reality, okay? Then in that state, you'll begin to see things as they really are, and you'll be closer to God. And then you just wait until he makes you aware of little this or little that. And the first things you'll become aware of won't be shining truths. The first thing you'll become aware of will be your own wrongs. So it's, awakening is a little bit painful, but after the pain comes relief, comes joy. Okay? My name is Pastor Roland.